सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां स्मदाचार्य प्रियंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमव्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति स्मितगुम्भदेवमात्मवत्य प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः श्री चेद्विघ्न गणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलपारं सर्ववेदान्त वैद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवान्नमत्वं यत्मे निश्चितामतिः। लास्ट पार्ट वी सॉ दैट दृढ़ज्ञानी अदृढ़ज्ञानी एंड उत्तम जिज्ञासु डू नॉट नीड कर्मोपासना because they don't have adhikara there. Now, karma adhikara is not there for any mumukshu is being mentioned here as long as that person is a moksha ichchu. And when you say moksha ichchu or mumukshu, that means that the person has no other interest. So that is the 409th avarta here. Asanjata bodha yaha. उत्तम जिज्ञासु वन हु हैज नॉट डन श्रवण और ड्यूरिंग श्रवण ऑल्सो द श्रवण स्टेज इज नॉट कंप्लीट दो द ज्ञान हैज नॉट अराइजन सो असंजात बोध वन हु हैज नॉट अंडरस्टूड द ऐक्य बट इज एन उत्तम जिज्ञासु सो उत्तम जिज्ञासु मीन्स कर्म उपासना हैज बीन डन इनफैक्ट भगवान विद्यारण्याचार्य सेज दैट उत्तम जिज्ञासु इज वन हु इज अ कृतोपास्ति कृतोपास्ति इज वन हु हैज डन उपासना टू कल्मिनेशन टू इष्ट देवता दर्शन इत्यादि बट एनीवे उत्तम जिज्ञासु वी नो हु हैज चित्त शुद्धि सो चित्त शुद्धि इज इनफ बट श्रवण हैज नॉट रेक्टिफाइड येट यश्च मंद जिज्ञासु एंड वन हु इज अ मंद जिज्ञासु तयोर उभयोरपि कर्मोपासनयोर अनधिकारः इवन दैट काइंड ऑफ अ पर्सन मंद अधिकारी आल्सो बट एन अधिकारी नंदलेस डज नॉट हैव अधिकार इन कर्म उपासना बिकॉज वंस ज्ञान अधिकार कम्स इन व्हेन द अकर्ता अभोक्ता ज्ञान takes place, whether aikya jnana has taken place or not, when akarta abhokta jnana takes place, then karma adhikara is anyway gone. Because karma adhikara we have seen is for a person who has dehatma buddhi aparokshataya and parokshataya atma buddhi. What is that atma buddhi? Karta abhokta atma. Who is shariirat traya vyatirikta. शरीरत्रय व्यतिरिक्त आत्मज्ञान इफ इट बिकम्स द ज्ञान ऑफ एन ऑफ अकर्ता एंड अभोक्ता देन एनी वे कर्माधिकार इजंट देयर बिकॉज फॉर हूम आर यू डूइंग कर्म एंड उपासना फॉर हूम हु इज गोइंग टू गेट द रिजल्ट इफ यू आर नॉट द कर्ता यू आर एनी वे नॉट गोइंग टू गेट द रिजल्ट देन वाई वुड एनी वन डू कर्म एंड उपासना देयर फॉर अ कर्मी is definitely one who has atmajnana which is dehatraya vyatirikta but a karta definitely a karta not an akarta atma therefore for them also there is no karma and upasana adhikara chitta shuddhi also is for whom one who has chitta will have chitta shuddhi one who has no sangha with the chitta asanga atma cannot have any chitta shuddhi has nothing to do with the chitta mala or chitta shuddhi that is described in detail further yasya bodho na sanjatah the type here sanjatah kintu tivratara atmajnana ichcha asti so this much is our understanding usually But the next statement is forgotten. Bhogeccha cha nasti. Bhogeccha nasti. There should be no bhogeccha. This is the make or break for adhikara. So bodha is not important for adhikara in making or breaking an adhikari in karma or jnana. So one who has adhikara in karma has no adhikara in jnana. One who has adhikara in jnana has no adhikara in karma. They are mutually exclusive really. So yasya bodha, atma bodha, which kind of aikya? Here bodha is aikya, in advaita it is aikya bodha. So yasya aikya bodha na sanjata. Kintu tivratara atma jnane cha asti. He wants to know that atma which is one with Brahma. Wants to know the real self which is one with Brahma. But has no bhogeccha. Does not want any laukika or alaukika, paralaukika bhoga. Tasya antakranam shuddham eva aste. That antakrana shuddhi is sufficient. In fact, why sufficient? Many people struggle across years, but this bhogeccha does not go. So this bhogeccha not going, vairagya isn't there. If vairagya isn't there, then viveka will not culminate into atma anatma. Viveka will not culminate into aikya. Therefore, antakkarana shuddhi is this bhogeccha not being there. Tasmat sa uttama jijnyasu rityuchyate. That person is uttama jijnyasu. Tasya bodha siddhaye sharvanadikam eva anushtheyam. What should he do? Sharvana manan nidhyasana na karmopasane. Karmopasaneyo phalabhuta antakkarana shuddhi naishchalyayo tasya siddhatvat. Why? Because uttama adhikari already has chitta shuddhi due to karma and upasana. Nothing else. He has practiced karma and upasana. Now he does not need to do it. Even if he does it, there is no phala to be acquired because the phala is already attained. Yaha jnane samanya iccha shravanado pravartate. So yaha jnane pravartate. One who has pravrutti unto jnana has to have nivrutti in karma and upasana. You cannot have both. So jnana iccha being there, he takes to jnana, and the means to jnana is shravana. Therefore shravanado pravartate. How? Samanya icchaya. There is a samanya iccha of this jnana. Let me see what is Shruti saying. But yasya cha antakranam bhoge asaktam sa manda jijnyasuhu. That person has some bhoge iccha also. But he has begun shravana now. If he has begun shravana, he is getting some jnana. He is a manda adhikari, manda jijnyasu. But he has jnana iccha. And he has already begun shravana, because shravana do pravartate. Once he has begun shravana, and if shravana is working, he is able to understand in bits and pieces, then also he need not do any karma upasana, he can drop it. This bhoga asakti will go over in time if he drops the karma. If he continues to do karma, this bhoga asakti will increase. And this is exactly why Bhagavan Bhashyakara says that on the first glimpse of vairagya, on knowing that there is no nitya sukha from vishaya bhoga, should leave home lock, stock and barrel. Anyway, this is an era which was different when Bhagavan Shankaracharya said, when dharma was flourishing, or it was there. There was scope to flourish, where he fueled the fire of dharma again and again across the nation. But considering that orthodoxy, person should take to vividisha sannyasa, that is being said here. So api sharvanam parityajya punarapi karma upasanayo pravartitum na arhati. It is not. He ought not go back to karma upasana. If he goes back, इट्स ओके, कर्म उपासना कैन लीड टू मोर एंड मोर चित्त शुद्धि एंड मेक हिम एन उत्तम अधिकारी. अनदर वे इज टू कंटिन्यू श्रवण. इफ श्रवण इज वर्किंग, इफ श्रवण इज नॉट वर्किंग देन ही हैज टू गो बैक टू कर्म उपासना, अदरवाइज ही नीड नॉट गो बैक. इन द टिप्पण the shravana manana and nididhyasana phalas are mentioned or who should do what. shrunvantu ajnana tattvaste janan kasma shrunomyaham manyantam samshayapanna nam namanye ama samshayah. so ajnata tattvah te ye ajnana tattvah ajnata tattvah those who have not understood the tattva दे शुड्डु श्रवण शुश्रुणवंतु ते शुणवंतु. एंड आय हू हैव अंडरस्टूड दैट आफ्टर श्रवण आई हैव अंडरस्टूड देर इज नो नेसेसिटी ऑफ फर्दर श्रवण. कस्मात् अहम यह आत्मतत्त्वम जानन सो ज्ञात तत्त्वः अहम यह आत्मतत्त्वम जानन दैट कैंड ऑफ तादृश अहम कस्मात् श्रुणोमि. सो वाई वुड आई डू श्रवण अगेन, नीड नॉट डू. सो पर्सन हू इज वेरी क्लियर एज टू वॉट शास्त्र तात्पर्य इज नीड नॉट डू श्रवण ऑल्सो. वॉट एवर लिटिल श्रवण हैज फ्रक्टिफाइड ही हैज डन श्रवण इन द अर्लियर जन्म नीड नॉट डू एनी अदर श्रवण. वाई बिकॉज विद्या माया दैट विल ऑल्सो ग्रास्प यू. सो आई नीड मोर उपनिषद्स, आई नीड मोर यू नो प्रकरण ग्रंथास, आई वुड लव टू हैव मोर दर्शन शास्त्र न्याय पूर्व मीमांसा सांख्य योगा. आई वुड लव टू लर्न ऑल दैट. इट्स ओके टू लर्न ऑल दैट बट नॉट फॉर मोक्ष. आई डोंट नीड एनीथिंग फॉर मोक्ष फर्दर देन आई कैन गो टू मनन. मन्यंताम संशयापन्नः ये संशयापन्नः दोज हु हैव डाउट्स दैट शास्त्र सेइंग यू आर ब्रह्म बट स्टिल आई एम नॉट ब्रह्म आई डोंट नो हाउ आई कैन बी that ananta brahma sarvashaktiman brahma that kind of brahma I don't know how I can be. those who have samshayas they should do manana. so manyantam te samshayapannaha ye te manyantam na manye aham asamshayah. I who have no samshaya also why would I do manana also. therefore what should I do. I can go to nididhyasana. although they are the overlapping stages they need not be overlapping also. one who has clear ideas about what shastra says and has no doubts about it, in fact one who sees that there is no other way that moksha is possible, jnanena eva moksha and this is that jnana and now I don't need any other means because I am already free, I was never bound, so much so that I have to be brahma. There is no other possibility also. One who has that understanding does not need anything else. Viparyasto nididhyaset kim dhyanam aviparyayat. So viparyayah. So viparyaya one. So viparyastah nididhyaset. One who has this viparita bhavana, viparyaya. Let that person. डू निधि ध्यासन किम ध्यानम अविपर्ययात. इफ देर इज नो विपर्या और विपरीत भावना आई नो दैट आई एम ब्रह्म आई नेवर बिकम अ जीव आई डोंट गेट जीव भाव एट ऑल आई डोंट गेट दी अंतवत जीव भाव देन वाई वुड आई डू ध्यान ऑल्सो. किम ध्यानम वॉट ध्यान शुड बी डन एंड ध्यान हियर इज नॉट उपासना इज निधि ध्यासन ऑल्सो. देहात्मत्व विपर्यासम न कदाचित भजाम्यहम अहम न भजामि अहम कदाचित अपि देहात्म विपर्यासम न भजामि. आई डोंट इवन पार्टेक ऑफ दिस जीवत्व भाव इवन एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ एनी सराउंडिंग एनी सर्कमस्टेंस लेफ्ट अलोन इन द क्राउड हाउएवर इट इज देन व्हाई वुड आई डू निधिध्यासन ऑल्सो. तत्वबोध शून्यस्य श्रवणम संशयवतः मननम विपर्यस्तस्य अन्यथा प्रतिपन्नस्य निदिध्यासनम च कर्तव्यत्वेन चोदितम्. दि श्रुति गिव्स अ विधि एज श्रवण श्रोतव्य मंतव्य निदिध्यासितव्य for those who have no tattva bodha, those who have doubts, and those who have viparita bhavana respectively. Ajnana samshaya viparyasa shunyasya tattva vidaha na kinchidapi kartavyamasti. Whereas one who has no ajnana, has no samshaya also, and has no viparita bhavana, that kind of a tattva vid has nothing to be done. He is a kritakritya. So you have seen this anyway. But here, manda jijnyasu also need not go back to karma upasana. Karma upasana phalabhuta antakrana shuddhi naishchalye shravani naiva tasya siddhe bhavataha. So the siddhi of karma and upasana, which is chitta shuddhi and chitta achanchalata, that is possible through Shravana itself. But we have to understand this. When Shravana itself is said, then nothing but Shravana. One cannot be doing anything and everything in one's life and then Shravana also. That won't work. So many people misunderstand this, that once Shravana has started, one need not do anything else. And then they stop doing Nitya Naimittika Karma Ityadi. That is not right. It won't work. The good way to see it is that what is the real means to Chitta Shuddhi? See, Shravana causing Chitta Shuddhi is a side effect of Shravana. Shravana causing Vairagya is also side effect of Shravana. It is not the main effect. Main effect is Aikya Jnanotpatti. Obviously, Aikya Jnanotpatti and Ashuddha Chitta cannot go together. Therefore, Chitta Shuddhi is going to be a consequence anyway. But it is not a main effect. What is the main effect for which karma, the means are prescribed for Chitta Shuddhi? What is the main effect? When Chitta Shuddhi has to be main effect, what is prescribed is karma and upasana. So example is, you can dry the wood. If the wood isn't dry, which is used in the homa, you can put it in the homa and it will dry. But it will be smoky. That is not the means of drying wood. What is the means of drying wood? You put it out in the sun, in a dry area where there is no wetness. You can't put it in the on wet ground and expect the wood to dry. You cannot even directly put it into Homa Agni and assume that the fire will be drying the wood. It will dry the wood, but that is not the purpose of, that's a side effect of the fire, the burning fire. That's not the main effect. The main effect is to consume that wood or consume the homa which is being offered, ahuti being offered, but the main use of that homa agni is not to dry wood. It will still dry wood. And now that if you have begun the homa and you have already put the wood inside, you need not take it out and put it out in the sun to dry. You already put it, you live with the smoke now. You manage with the smoke and get it over with. That is a good example I think fits here. So if you already begun Shravana, live with the smoke. It's okay. But you should be dropping off everything. Only then Shravana will work in Chitta Shuddhi. Otherwise, it will not give you Chitta Shuddhi so easy. So we have to take it with a pinch of salt. This is with a different setup where orthodoxy is completely around you. When we are not involved in, binge watching and stock trading and, growth in the company, that kind of a lifestyle won't work. It won't go together because karma, nitya naimittika karma, is to be the last one to be dropped. Not while saying that I have parents, I have children, I have family, I have spouse, everyone to be taken care of, and I should make money, I should stock for next 10 years, 20 years, 3 generations, whatever have you, and then say that Saravana is working. It won't work. So this has to be considered in the orthodoxy, that where only shravana is being done and one is maintaining the livelihood, that's all. Sharira yatra. Beyond that, if one is not indulging anything, there is no bhoga, there is bhoga ichha, but one is not indulging. That is a manda adhikari. Manda adhikari is one who has bhoga asakti, but then resources are dried off. You should kill off the resources. That asakti will die only when the resources are killed and you have walked out and are doing only shravana. Only then this will work. Otherwise, some people may misunderstand that manda jijnyasu can leave everything and do shravana and will get moksha. Will not get moksha. Definitely, he will be trapped. Neither here nor there. So, this will work only when person is doing only shravana. So, api shravanam parityajya punarapi karma upasanayo pravartitum na arhati. There is a tippana here. Nivruttam karma seveta pravruttam मत्परस्त्यजेत जिज्ञासायां संप्रवृत्ता नाद्रियेत कर्मचोदना. सो वन नीड नॉट फॉलो द कर्म एज कर्म एंड उपासना एज कर्तव्य इफ वन हैज यू नो वन हैज निवृत्त मोक्ष. दैट्स अ सेकंड पॉइंट. We are not reached there. So, karma upasana phalabhuta antakrana shuddhi naishchalye shravaneneva tasya siddhe bhavataha. Shravanasya avrutya eva antakrana doshasya nivrutya tasya iha janmani janmantariva brahmalokeva jnanam siddhet. It will not lead to jivan mukti do. If a person has taken to Vividisha Sannyasa and is continuing Shravana either in this Janma or in another Janma, Jivan Mukti is possible if he gets the Jnana in this Janma itself and becomes a Vidwan. So Shravanasya Avrutya, continuous Shravana, Punah Punah Shravana, if he keeps on doing, then Taya Eva अंतकरण दोषस्य निवृत्त्या तस्य इह जन्मनि जन्मांतरे वा ब्रह्मलोके वा ज्ञानं सिद्ध्येत. सो इन दिस जन्म जीवन मुक्ति इज पॉसिबल, इन अनदर जन्म जीवन मुक्ति इज पॉसिबल, और इन ब्रह्मलोक क्रम मुक्ति इज पॉसिबल. आवृत्ति नाम अभ्यास. सो आवृत्ति श्रवणस्य आवृत्ति हैज इज बीन मेंशन. सो इट इज अभ्यास रिपीटेशन ऑफ श्रवण. पुनः पुनः कुर्यात् श्रवणम. इट इज सेड that is true, applicable for everyone, but at the cost of everything else. Punah punah anushthanam. Sadhana anushthane prayatna dhara iti avat. So prayatna dhara, one has to keep on putting effort to understand whatever is being taught. Again and again, one has to put the effort tirelessly. Shravanam parityajya karma upasanayo pravartamanaha arudha patita itya vijiyate. So it is like, you know, somebody who has climbed the horse to ride the horse, but then falls off the horse. So one who has taken to jnana, but drops jnana, it's not working, and then goes back to karma upasana. It is like falling off a horse. So arudha patitaha. Tippadakara says, moksha sopanam aruya tatas chutasya arudha patitasya vishaye karastham payasam tyaktva कूर्परं लेडी दुर्मति ही इति प्रसिद्ध करण लेडी न्याय प्रसज्यते. सो करण लेडी न्याय इज यूज हियर सेइंग दैट यू ऑलरेडी गॉट दिस पायसा एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ ईटिंग द पायसम इन द बोल यू आर लिकिंग योर फिंगर्स. और हियर अनदर वे इट इज सेड इज दैट कूर्परं लेडी when you are eating payasa with your hand and instead of doing that you are trying to pick it up and on the corner of the vessel your elbow touched it and then elbow has payasa, you are trying to lick the elbow, which is next to impossible. So entire life goes in that trying to get moksha through karma and upasana when you already had shravana, which is the real means. So that is the comparison given. उपेक्ष्य तत्तीर्थ यात्रा जपादीनेव कुर्वतां पिंडं समुत्सृज्य करं लेडी इति न्याय आपतेत. सो दि करं लेडी न्याय इज एक्सप्लेन्ड. अपेक्ष्य अपरोक्ष ज्ञान साधन निर्गुण उपासना श्रवणादिकं परित्यज्य इत्यर्थः. सो इन द एग्जांपलिफाइड गिविंग अप श्रवण मन निधिध्यासन विच वन हैज ऑलरेडी टेकन टू लाइक द पायसा ऑलरेडी बीइंग सर्व्ड एंड वन हैज इट इन वन्स हैंड सिमिलर टू दैट इन द एग्जांपल वन गिव्स अप दैट पायसा एंड ट्राइज टू lick off the bits and pieces here and there. Instead of that, one can eat the payasa. Similarly here, shravana mana nididhyasana itself would have led to moksha, but giving that up, which is already begun, one goes back and does karma upasana, that isn't right. Ittham cha jnaninaha uttama jinyasuscha karma upasana yor adhikaraha nasti. So jnani does not have adhikara in karma upasana. Uttama jijnyasu does not have any adhikara in karma and upasana. Manda jijnyasu yaha vedanta shravane pravruttaha tasya api adhikara nasti. Somehow by earlier punya working, if a manda jijnyasu has some interest on the sidelines and happens to be dragged to some pravachana somewhere, does some shravana, even that person has no adhikara in karma upasana if that knowledge starts working in bits and pieces. Yasya jnani ichcha asti parantu buddhi bhoge asakta. So buddhi, yasya buddhi, meaning buddhi asakta is ichcha basically. There is bhoge ichcha, that's the idea there. So yasya jnane ichcha asti and also ichcha in bhoga. Tasmat shravanena pravartate tasya manda jijnyaso nishkama karmani upasane cha adhikara asti. That person should not drop karma and upasana. One who has asakti in bhoga. Generally, everyone has asakti in bhoga unless one is an uttama adhikari. Manda adhikari is definitely going to have bhogeccha. This so moksha also, let there be moksha also, that is the masses. So that's a group of people who are interested, okay, let me look into moksha also. This may be there for many. However, shravana is not taken to. It is postponed, say, okay, after retirement, something to do, pastime activity. They should not drop karma upasana. But those who have begun shravana, the bhogeccha will go on its own if they drop everything and continue to do that. They need not entertain that bhoga. If they continue karma upasana, bhogeccha will become dhrida. So therefore, nishkama karmani upasane cha adhikarasti. In karma, in a sense, karma yoga, one has adhikara in. यस्य तु भोगे एव इच्छा अस्ति ज्ञाने इच्छा नास्ति स बहिर्मुख इति कीर्त्यते. बहिर्मुख इज वन इज हु इज इंटरेस्टेड ओनली इन भोगा, हैज नथिंग टू डू विद ज्ञान. इवन इफ समवन गिव्स हिम ज्ञान, ही डज नॉट वांट इट. तस्य सकाम कर्मणि अपि अधिकार अस्ति. सो दैट पर्सन हैज अधिकार इवन इन काम्य कर्म. तस्मात् ज्ञानिनः कर्म उपासनयोर अधिकारः नास्ति. कर्म उपासने ज्ञानस्य विरोधिनी. Fact is that karma and upasana are jnana virodhi because of being ajnana karya, ajnana being jnana virodhi. Karma upasane dhrida bodhasyana virodhini kintu manda bodhasya eva. Now karma and upasana cannot oppose jnana which is stronger. There is virodha of ajnana between jnana and ajnana. Vritti rupa jnana and karma upasana, which are ajnana karya, they definitely have virodha with each other. So how will jnana win? Only when it is stronger. Therefore, dhrida bodha and karma upasana have virodha. In which way? Dhrida bodha opposes karma upasana. Therefore, karma upasana cannot have virodha with dhrida bodha. If the karma upasana as a result of ajnana, they are stronger. Ajnana is stronger, therefore karma upasana will lead to more and more bhoga ichcha. They will oppose this manda bodha. If the jnana is not strong, then what will happen? If a person goes back to karma upasana, then karma upasana will oppose the manda bodha and jnana will not survive. Therefore it is said karma upasana dridha bodhasya na virodini. They are not going to oppose the firm knowledge. So one can remain in as a vidvat grahastha, one can remain. He does not need to take sannyasa if there is strong jnana, dridha bodha. So Yajnavalkya took sannyasa for jivan mukti ananda. For not for jivan mukti in the sense, not for moksha. Moksha, videha mukti was guaranteed for Yajnavalkya. He knew that. But then he wanted jivan mukti ananda also. But people who have manda bodha, if they go back to karma upasana, it will oppose manda bodha. Dridha bodhasya karma upasanayuscha avirodha. How is it that the dridha bodha, the firm understanding of aikya and karma upasana do not have any contradiction or opposition to each other? Yadyapi karma upasane api antakkaranasya shuddhi naishchalya sampadana dvara jnanotpattim prati hetu bhavatah tathapi jnanotpatter anantaram karma upasanayor anushthane utpannam api jnanam nashyet. इति हेतु होते ज्ञान विरोधिनी न ज्ञान इच्छा हेतु भवतः. सो यद्यपि कर्मोपासने अपि अंतकरण शुद्धि नैश्चल संपादन द्वारा ज्ञानोत्पत्ति प्रति हेतु भवतः. दे आर दी इनडायरेक्ट कॉज फॉर ज्ञान. चित्त शुद्धि एंड नैश्चल्य, चित्त नैश्चल्य आर दी इफेक्ट ऑफ कर्म एंड उपासना रिस्पेक्टिवली. देयरफॉर क्रमेण दे आर ऑल्सो कारण. तथापि ज्ञानोत्पत्तेर अनंतरम वंस दी ज्ञान हैज टेकन प्लेस देन कर्म उपासना बीइंग अज्ञान कार्य दे विल फ्यूल दी अज्ञान. दे विल मेक अज्ञान स्ट्रॉन्गर. देयरफॉर व्हाट विल हैपन उत्पन्नमपि ज्ञानम नश्येत इति हेतोः ते ज्ञान विरोधिनी न ज्ञान इच्छा हेतु भवता. दे विल कीप ऑन टेकिंग अवे योर ज्ञान इच्छा. सो कर्म उपासना आर दिस इज द बेसिक सेटअप. कर्म उपासना आर अपोज टू ज्ञान एनीवे. सो ज्ञान इच्छा एंड कर्म इच्छा, कर्म और भोग इच्छा कैन नॉट गो टुगेदर. दैट इज द बेसिक सेटअप. अहम कर्ता यज्ञादिकं मया कर्तव्यं यज्ञादि स्वर्गः फलम् इति भेद बुद्ध्या कर्म अनुष्ठीयते. सो हु डज कर्म, हु नोज दैट आई एम कर्ता, आई विल डू यज्ञ इत्यादि, थ्रू दोज मीन्स आई विल अटेन स्वर्ग एज अ फला ऑफ यज्ञ इत्यादि. अहम उपासक देव उपास्यः इति भेद बुद्ध्या उपासनम अनुष्ठीयते. सो भेद बुद्धि इज नीडेड इवन फॉर उपासना. ते द्वे अपि बुद्धि सर्वं खल्विदं ब्रह्म इति बुद्धिं दूरीकृत्येव भवतः. यू कैन नॉट से दैट एवरीथिंग इज ब्रह्म, ब्रह्म बीइंग मी आई, एंड से दैट आई विल डू कर्म एंड गेट दैट फल. यू आर ऑलरेडी दैट. यू कैन नॉट से उपासना इज अ मीन्स टू अटेन सम फल विच इज ऑलरेडी यू. सर्वं खल्विदं ब्रह्म, दे कैन नॉट गो टुगेदर. तस्मात् कर्म उपासने ज्ञानस्य विरोधिनी. यू कैन नॉट हैव ऐक्य ज्ञान एंड डू कर्म उपासना द वे इट इज प्रिस्क्राइब्ड. विद्भेद बुद्धि यद्यपि ज्ञानी आत्मानं असंगतया जानाति तथापि भोजनादि रूपं देहव्यवहारं वा जनकादिवत् तथापि अधिकं राज्यपालनादि व्यवहारं वा करोत्येव. सो ज्ञानी नोज दैट आत्मा इज असंग, देयरफॉर तथापि, बट स्टिल ही डज व्हाट, भोजन व्यवहार. इन भोजन he is going to eat only what he has been eating, or maybe lesser or less, slightly different, but that which is bhojya itself he is eating. He is not eating stones with aikya buddhi. And he is not even saying that since bhojana and I am one, aham annam aham annam aham annam. Therefore, he does not say that I will not eat anna also because I am anna. He does not take that literally. The Taittiriya mantra. So, dehadi vyavahara is there. Whether it is bhojana or vichara, manasa karma is also there. Janakadivat tathapi adhikam rajyapalanadi vyavaharam va karoti eva. So, Janaka, common example for grahastha jnani, who continued to be following his rajya dharma because he was a kshatriya. So, he continued rajyapalanadi vyavahara, not thinking that rajya does not exist because it is brahma. Tasya vyavaharasya jnanam na virodhi bhavati. So there, this jnana and vyavahara do not have opposition because dhrida jnana is there. Nava vyavaharo jnanasya virodhi bhavati. There is no opposition any which way. It is not that the vyavahara is going to overpower dhrida jnana and or dhrida jnana is going to overpower vyavahara. If it does, what will happen? People will say, get me a better king than Janaka, who says that enemy is also one of us, we don't care. Why? Because sarvam khalvidam brahma. That jnana is not interfering with his kshatriya dharma. And the kshatriya dharma is not, although it is ajnana karya, it is not interfering with his aikya jnana. There are different levels. Vyavaharika satta and paramarthika satta are not interfering with each other. For people like Janaka who have dhrida jnana or Bhikshuka sannyasis who have dhrida jnana, who go for bhiksha, there is no contradiction between them. One will not belittle the other. Tathahi yada atmaswarupam jnanena asangataya jnatam yad, sorry, tathahi yada atmaswarupam jnanena asangataya jnatam tasmin atmani yadi vyavahara pratitaha bhavet tada vyavaharasya jnanam virodhi syat. When is there virodha? Yad atmaswarupam jnanena asangataya jnatam. That atmaswarupa which is asanga, it is known so. Tasmin atmani yadi vyavahara pratitaha bhavet. Only if Janaka, for example, thinks that this asanga atma is now having sangha with rajyapalana dharma, then there is contradiction. But he wouldn't be thinking so. A bhikshuka sannyasi who goes for bhiksha for sharira yatra, sharira has to be there. As long as prarabdha is there, it is entrusted to me, I have to take care of it. That kind of me is not asanga atma. But the asanga atma who somehow happens to be associated, somehow in the sense mithya, who is not really associated, that asanga atma was always asanga even before jnanotpatti, had nothing to do with bhojanadi karma. Therefore, there is no bhojanadi or bhiksha karma in atma, in me. In me really, there is no kartrakaraka. There is no kartari sense in this, in bhiksha also. Within the atma that I am, therefore, there is no pratiti of vyavahara, bhiksha or rajapalana as the case may be. Tada, so if it is there, yadi vyavahara pratita bhavet, tada vyavaharasya jnana virodhi syat, then this jnana will oppose that. Because aikya jnana of this asanga atma, who is ekamayava dvitiya, that atma cannot have any kriya at all. There cannot be vyavahara pratiti also. If it is there, then there is virodha. Jnanasya cha vyavahara virodhi bhavet. And then vyavahara will oppose jnana, jnana will oppose vyavahara. Both ways there is opposition. Vidushastu sa vyavahara atmani na pratiyate. For a vidwan, there is no such pratiti of vyavahara in atma. Sarvo vyavahara ha dehadyashraya ha vyavahara sahita dehadinam atmani sambandho nasti. So all vyavahara is taking place in deha, stula or sukshma, mana ityadi, indriya, but I have nothing to do with it. Same thing which we have seen many a time. गुणागुणेषु वर्तन्ते व्यवहार सहित देहादीनां whether it is deha which has vyavahara or vyavahara itself has no direct presence in atma has no sangha with atma at all therefore atmani sambandha nasti iti anaya buddhya jnani sarva vyavaharan karoti so he has that understanding he does not even have to think and work on that atah vidusha pravruttirapi nivruttireva so he is प्रवृत्ति इन कर्म और उपासना और वट एवर इज डूइंग वेदर राज्य पालना भिक्षा और गृहस्थ ज्ञानी डूइंग गृहस्थ धर्म बिकॉज वॉट इज नित्य नैमित्तिक कर्म फॉर जनक हु इज अ क्षत्रिय राजा राज्य पालना इज नित्य कर्म ही हैज टू डू दैट एज अ क्षत्रिय अदर देन संध्या वंदना इत्यादि राज्य पालना इज ऑल्सो इज कर्म So he has to do that. He didn't give that up. He didn't stay at home and say that I'll not do karma. He continued to do the karma because he stayed at home in that same ashrama. Thereby, his karma is not karma. What is it then? It is karma bhasa. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says in Gita that jnani's karma is not karma. It is karma bhasa. For the others, it may be karma. But it is an abhasa really because jnani is atma brahma which never had karma even before jnanotpatti therefore after jnanotpatti also there is no karma although others feel so jnani himself does not have any karma bhavana at all that I am doing karma for a particular purpose none of those ideas are there he continues to do what he is doing because the sharira continues to do what comes about by prarabdha so that pravritti is also nivritti there are too many shlokas here I'll just go through that there is a tippana on this vyavahara jagat satyatvam apadya prarabdham bhojaye yadi yada virodhi vidyaya bhoga matranna satyata yadi vidya pannu vita यदि विद्यापन्नुवीत हकार नकार हकार इन एसोसिएशन हकार मकार नकार गेट इंटरचेंज सो जनरली वी डोंट राइट दिस यू नो विथ हकार एज अ हल नकार गोज बिलो सो इट समटाइम्स इट्स अ ओल्ड फॉन्ट्स आर लिटिल ट्रिकी यदि विद्यापन्नुवीत जगत प्रारब्ध धातिनी तदा स्यान्न तु मायात्व बोधेन तदपन्नवः सो हियर इट इज राइट मायामय प्रपंचोयम आत्मा चैतन्य रूपधुक् सो मायामय प्रपंच अयम आत्मा चैतन्य रूपधुक् इति बोधे विरोध को लौकिक व्यवहारिणः अपेक्षते व्यवहृतिर् न प्रपंचस्य वस्तुतां नाप्यात्म जाड्यं किं त्वेषा साधनान्येव कांक्षति मनोवाक् काय तद्बाह्य पदार्था साधनानि तान् तत्त्ववित् न उपमृद्गेति मृद्नाति सॉरी दिस इज मृद्नातिया व्यवहारस्य न कुतः सो टू मेनी श्लोकास हैव बीन क्लोटेड हियर ज्ञानं प्रारब्धजन्य व्यवहार अविरोधीति भावः कंक्लूजन इज सिंपल ज्ञानं प्रारब्धजन्य व्यवहार अविरोधी प्रारब्ध विल कॉज व्यवहार Because prarabdha has been affecting sharira traya and the sharira traya which are guna karyas, guna and gunas will have association and the way they had earlier, whether there is jnana or no jnana has nothing to do with the prarabdha continuing to affect the sharira. So that will continue. So jnanam prarabdha janya vyavahara avirodhi jnana is not opposed to prarabdha janya vyavahara it cannot stop it also otherwise what will happen is that if it is prarabdha virodhi then prarabdha will end as soon as jnanotpatti takes place there won't be a jnani at all as soon as the person becomes a jnani the sharira will be dropped because prarabdha is over if prarabdha is over then sharira will not survive where will the jnani be to teach so we will not have any jnani in the sampradaya itself all that bhakti you can set aside. Therefore, prarabdha janya vyavahara will be there even after jnana. So anyway, I'll not go into details too much to analyze also. We are interested in tatpurya. I may have made mistakes also in chanting. So our tatpurya is this, prarabdha janya vyavahara avirodhi. विदुषस्तु सह व्यवहार आत्मनि न प्रतीयते सर्व व्यवहार देहाद्याश्रयः व्यवहार सहित देहादीनाम आत्मनि संबंधो नास्ति. दिस मच वी नो एज अ फैक्ट. देयरफॉर इति अनया बुद्ध्या ज्ञानी सर्व व्यवहारान करोति प्रारब्धादीना अतः विदुषा प्रवृत्तिरपि निवृत्तिरेव. सो दिस कर्म इज कर्माभास फॉर ज्ञानी. सो दैट इज सेड हियर ज्ञानी न कर्म आभास रूपमेव. ज्ञानी कर्म इज कर्माभासा यथा ज्ञानिनो भोजनादि रूप व्यवहार न ज्ञानस्य विरोधी तथा आत्मा असंगः क्रिया सर्वाः मनोवाक्काय आश्रिताः इति ज्ञात्वा क्रियमाणे कर्मोपासने न ज्ञानस्य विरोधिनी. When a person is doing karma or upasana, sankalpa is what? Let me get this amuka karma, amuka phala. Let me get this upasana phala. This is the sankalpa which one starts off with. Every karma and upasana starts with a sankalpa. So, yatha jnaninaha bhojanadi rupa vyavahara na jnanasya virodhi. When one jnani is eating food, he does not have any issue with his jnana. Hunger drives him to food by, be it by madhukara vritti or by ajagara vritti. Whichever vritti is, whether he waits for food to come to be delivered, if it comes, he eats, otherwise he does upvasa, or he goes, you know, to three or five houses and takes bhiksha. Whatever he gets, well and good, does not get upvasa. That has nothing to do with his jnana. He does not think that I am a jnani, I should not eat. So it is ridiculous because deha eats, deha is hungry. Jnani was never hungry, atma is never hungry. So bhojanadi rupa is not vyavahara is not opposed to jnana. Similarly, other vyavahara is also not really opposed to jnana. Atma asangaha, because atma is asanga, never has any sangha with deha traya. Therefore, karya, their own karyas are also not opposed to this atma. They don't attach to atma. Kriya sarva manovakaya shrita. So manasa karma, vak karma or kayika karma. Vachika karma or kayika karma has nothing to do with the atma at all. There is no atmika karma. Nothing like that. Iti jnatva kriyamane karma upasane na jnanasya virodhini. Once that understanding is there, then the karma is not going to affect a person at all. They will not oppose jnana. Yadi vidvan asangatvena jnatam atmanam karta iti matva karma upasane kuryat tada jnanasya te karma upasane virodhini bhavetam. When will karma and upasana be opposed to jnana? When? Yadi vidvan asangatvena jnatam atmanam karta iti matva. If he says, no, I have to do this, as soon as that thinking, no, I have to do this, that comes in, the person has become karta. Once he has become karta, then karma upasana will start giving results also. And then they will also bind. Therefore, they will leave vasanas, they will create more and more punya and papa to bind a person. And then they'll take away jnana also. They'll be opposed to this vritti rupa jnana because akarta atma jnana and karta karmi cannot be together. Sahayam atmanaha asangatva visheyakaha dhrida nishcheha vidusha karmopasana abhyam naduri bhavati. So jnani's understanding is dhrida, therefore it will not go away by karma upasana for a vidwan. Because dhrida nishchaya is there, it is samshaya rahita. Therefore, atma asangatva never goes away. That jnana, atma asangatva jnana never goes away for a vidwan, even when he is doing karma upasana. Tasmad abhasa rupe karma upasane dhrida bodhasya na virodhini. Atayeva janakadaya abhasa rupam karma karma anushtitavantaha. So whether it is Janaka or anyone else, they have done karma, but they were all abhasa rupa karma. Abhasa cannot have any opposition to any real existent thing. Atma asanga sarvaha kriyaha manovakaya shita iti jnatva kriyamane karma upasane abhasa rupe bhavataha. So the tippanakara is mentioning whatever was, in fact it is said in the, he is quoted that in the Moola, what is there, but then he said that, what is that? That is Abhasa Rupa. What is Abhasa Rupa? He is mentioned. That Jnana itself is this Jnana, that there is Kayika, Vachika and Manasika Karma. I have nothing to do with any karma, because every karma can be traced to what? Kaya, Deha, Vak or Mana. I can always be separate. That Jnana itself is going to lead to Abhasa Rupa Karma. If there is a Kartrutva Bhava, then it is not Abhasa Rupa Karma. Kartavyatva Bhava will bring in karma, real karma and karma phala. Atmanam asangam jnatva itara vyavaharavat vaidika shubha karmadyanushthanam api dehadi dharma ityeva jnatva vidusha kriyamanam shubham karma Abhasa Rupam eva. So one does punya karma also, it is abhasa rupa. Tasya api jnanena sa virodha nasti. That karma, even kamya karma, cannot bring any bandha to a jnani. He may do it for loka sangra, whatever is the purpose is irrelevant, but he has no kartrutva bhava. That much is important there, because atmanam asangam jnatva. भाष्यकारादिभिः कर्मोपासनयोर् ज्ञानेन यः विरोधः उक्तः सः आत्मा कर्ता भोक्ता च इति ज्ञानपूर्वकं क्रियमाण कर्मोपासन विषयः. इवन भगवान भाष्यकार हैज एग्जॉस्टिवली अपोज दिस और शोन कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन ऑफ द ज्ञान एंड कर्म. ज्ञान कर्म समुच्चय इज इम्पॉसिबल. ही हैज शोन एट मेनी प्लेसेस देयर व्हाट काइंड ऑफ कर्म, the karma which has opposition to jnana, or jnana has opposition to karma, that kind of karma is jnana purvakam, which is ajnana purvakam, really ajnana karya jnana purvakam. This jnana is what? This is bhranti jnana purvakam, preceded by jnana, which is actually a bhranti, that atma karta bhokta cha. So kartrutva jnana, bhoktrutva jnana, aham karta, aham bhokta, that jnana preceding whatever karma is being done, only that karma cannot have samuchaya with jnana. So therefore, there is no contradiction in what sadhu is saying and what Bhagavan Bhashyakara is saying. Natu abhasa rupa karma upasana vishaya. So abhasa rupa karma, which Bhagavan Bhashyakara himself says, karma abhasa, jnani's karma is karma abhasa. So, abhasa karma and jnana has no virodha. Mandabodhasya karma upasanayoscha virodha eva. However, mandabodha, if one has little understanding which does not stay. You know, our Acharya used to say, 2 o'clock question. In the case of Vyakrana, I used to say that. Vyakrana Acharya used to say, 2 o'clock question. If I wake you up at 2 o'clock at night and ask you some forms, some basic rules of Vyakrana, you should be able to answer. So something which is very important should become your second nature. So even if you are woken up in the middle of the night, you should be able to make no error and state it. So this is like this. Jnana, actually it is not second nature, it is your real nature. So your real nature should become second nature. Meaning in the antakkarana also the same real nature should continue. I am akarta abhokta, and here what is at 2 o'clock? 2 o'clock is the worst of the circumstances. When you are in the worst of the circumstances, even then one considering that, you know, why me? Why am I troubled? You know, why my relatives? All these ideas should not come up. Ahankara, mamakara should not be there at all. Doing the karma also, that ahankara has to precede in that karma. That kind of thinking shouldn't be there. That bhranti should not be there in the worst of the situations. That is akartrutva bhava, which is real nature becoming second nature. But if it isn't there, if it is only after the mind has become still, only then if you can bring back this knowledge that I am akarta. So if it is an afterthought, a postmortem, then it is mandabodha. So I do everything in the spur of the moment, but then I say that I shouldn't have done this. Like any other laukika vyavahara. In laukika vyavahara also, there are many times, you know, we get carried away. Due to whatever it is, raga, dvesha, anger, kama, krodha. And then there is an afterthought, oh, this is not good for me. I shouldn't have done this, you know. Maybe, you know, next time I'll mark it, I'll make a diary note. This is not a diary note. So, if you gather back your real nature, where memory is needed, if you have dependency on smriti, then that jnana is manda. So, manda bodhasya karma upasanavishya virodha eva. Then there will be contradiction, because there won't be karma abhasa. One starts with karma abhasa, oh, it doesn't affect me, what? I mean, Janaka did it. Why can't I do it? So this is the thinking. Many people say that they want to become Janakas. Becoming Janaka is not, it is not a child's play. It is more difficult than even sannyasi who is in an appropriate, in the right circumstances, in the right surroundings. So it is very difficult. Thereby, mandabodha. One starts with mandabodha, one starts doing karma and upasana, continues to do that, thinking that I can survive any onslaught of karma, any prarabdha onslaught. How? I will not get into it completely because I am akarta. With that thinking, if one continues and gets dragged into it, and then there is an afterthought that, oh, it will not affect me because I am akarta. During the karma, do you still not lose your jnana, then it is not mandabodha. Otherwise, it is mandabodha. I may think later that someone asked me, why did you do all this? You know, I didn't do it. I mean, I am a karta. I have nothing to do with karma. This is all okay when you have a still mind and in arguments and debates. But are you being true to yourself? If I ask myself, am I true to myself? Is the answer yes all the time that I have dhrida jnana, then it is okay. Then the balance is also so that punya or papa, happiness or sorrow, both I weigh equally. Samatva bhava should be there. I cannot say that all that good that has been done, I claim it with ego, and all that has happened, we say prarabdha is like that. Both are prarabdha or both are due to free will. You cannot have this, like a surrogate mother or a stepmother. You cannot have that kind of a thinking. That I care for some, I don't care for some. So being true to yourself, if jnana can be retained in the worst of the circumstances, then it is not mandabodha. Otherwise, what happens is mandabodhasya tu abhasa rupe api karma upasane virodhini. Abhasa rupa karma will become real karma. It will not be abhasa rupa karma anymore. It won't be karma abhasa, it will be karma. And then they will have virodha with karma and upasana, will have virodha with jnana, that manda bodha will also go away. Samshaya adi sahito bodha manda bodha itti uchyate. Samshaya is there, and that samshaya atma vinashyati, that will hold good in this case, because someone or something else will keep on feeding that samshaya more and more. It will keep on clouding further and further, and this manda bodha will be abodha. यस्य अंतकरणे आत्मा असंगो वा किं वा न तथा इति कदाचित् संशयो जायते स पुरुषः आत्मा असंगः एव न मे कर्तव्यं किञ्चित् अप्यस्ति इति वारं वारं अनुसंधानं कुर्यात्. One has to confirm the idea, affirm the idea, keep on reasserting the idea that I am not karta, I am asanga atma. Sometimes, you know, this idea of Sangha comes in, there he has to do this abhyas of I am a Sangha. Varam varam, continuously, one has to keep on doing. In each and every circumstance, one should bring back this idea that I am a Sangha Atma. Otherwise, it won't stay. This is for a person who has Mandabodha, where Samshaya is there. Thereby, Namek कर्तव्यम किंचिदपि अस्ति. आई एम डूइंग इट बट आई नीड नॉट डू इट. दिस शुड बी वेरी क्लियर. इट इज नॉट दैट यू नो आई एम ड्रिंकिंग टी बिकॉज आई लाइक इट बट आई से आई कैन डू विदाउट टी. इफ द टी इज इंट देयर आई गेट हेडेक देन आई कंप्लेन द टी इज इंट गिवन. कॉफी इज इंट देयर ऑन टाइम. माई कॉफी इज ओवर. आई फॉरगॉट टू गेट इट. यू नो आई कांट गो आउट नाउ. ऑल दीज आइडियाज इफ दे कम अप दे विल ट्रबल द पर्सन. देन the person is thinking the body as oneself. I'm giving simple idea because these are the examples given to differentiate between binding and non-binding desire. Non-binding desire and binding desire is known only to oneself. Whether it is binding or non-binding, one will be bound if one keeps on thinking about it, thinking that atma is sanghi. Because the body has headache, let it have. Can one give it up? One cannot give up. Then it will bind. So the drinking of tea is no longer non-binding. It is binding. So just as an example. So iti varam varam anusandhanam kurya. The practice has to be continuous. Varam varam is continuously. Really, it is not occasional. Evam anuchintayata kalena samshe nivrutya dridabodho jayeta. So then jayeta is again vidhiling here. There is a possibility, shakyarthi ling here, drudha bodha jayeta, there would be, possibly then the bodha will become drudha. By samshaya nivritti, if it is possible, then definite, then would definitely jayeta. But samshaya nivritti itself is not possible, then drudha bodha shakyarthi, maybe it will go in time. Tatha chintanam. अकुर्वन् यदि कर्मोपासने एव अनुतिष्ठेत् तदा जातोपि मंदबोध दूरी भवेत्. दैट इज व्हाई पीपल से दैट ज्ञान इज नॉट वर्किंग. व्हाई? कर्म कंटिन्यूज टू बी देयर. पीपल एक्सपेक्ट दैट आउट ऑफ 24 आवर्स यू डू 1 आवर ऑफ श्रवण एंड देन 23 आवर्स आर लाइक द अर्लियर प्री श्रवण डेज. वोंट वर्क. इफ वन कंटिन्यूज दैट मनन देन यस. बट देन if one does not chintanam akurvan, if I am not doing chintana of whatever sharmana I have done, as soon as I step out everything is gone, then I am a karta. Then yadi karma upasane eva anutishtet, this person, that is why manda adhikari also, who has manda bodha, if he does shravana continuously, then karma upasana can be dropped and have to be dropped really. If he continues to do karma and upasana without doing chintana, then what will happen? Karma upasana, 23 hours of karma and upasana, sleep, you know, I go to sleep, I have swapna, I have, you know, in the waking hours, I keep on doing whatever I was doing, then they will become more and more dhrida, obviously, it is, but obviously, it is quite logical. Then what happens? Jata api manda bodha. Duri bhave. Then what happens? Oh, it's okay. Today I don't need to do shravana. Then 2 days have gone. Catch up with recordings. Not needed. Then 1 week I can't do it. I can't catch up with backlog. Somehow sink in if possible. Now what is the point of sinking? So you drop off and then you forget. I'm not talking about this part. Huh? Any part. Huh? Whoever is your, you know, whatever you have been doing. Or not you. I mean, any of us. We have all faced this. So prarabdha brings in anything, you know, family member not well, I am not well, or acharya is not well, or internet not working, or office work is more, no, not able to sleep. So many reasons are there. So shubha karma always has some badha, more, in fact more. Therefore, the effort is also needed, that is more. In Shravana also, it is the same thing. After Shravana, if you drop off that chain of Shravana, then there is no use of that Shravana, because karma will become more strong and Ajnana will take away that little understanding also. So, Manda Bodha Duri Bhave Jata Api. Even if it is there, it can go. That is why Shravana Mana Nididhyasana Adhikara is also really in orthodoxy only for a sannyasi, because other karma will not let this take place. It will overpower because it is more, unless one keeps on doing chintana. thereby what happens? Aham karta bhokta iti viparita nischeva dridi bhavet. I am karta. 23 hours of the day, I am karta. Of course, shushupti you take away. And then you say 6 to 8 hours. Not a karta bhokta. Not an individual at all. Not a jiva. But other hours, except for that 1 hour of shravana, everything else, it is going to bring in viparita bhavana. Therefore, viparita nischaya eva dridi bhave. Tasman mandabodhodaya, tasman mandabodhodaya purvam eva karma upasane anushteye. Mandabodhodayanantaram na te anushteye. Therefore, one has to drop karma and upasana even after mandabodha. Otherwise, they will make the deha bhavana, viparita bhavana, stronger. Anyway, it's quite a long paragraph. Next, we'll look at it. The same topic continues for a good while, because how much ever we look into this, our pravritti continues. This is the issue which has been dealt with by sadhu repeatedly, repeatedly with different adhikaris, and showing how our thinking, even if we consider it as right, it does not move to the stage of application. As to, we say, okay, jnana karma samuchya is not possible, but all we do is jnana karma samuchya. If the manda bodha is there, then jnana does not stay. If drida bodha is there, it is not an issue. So for, it is for each one to decide as to how much one should spend time in shravana manana and how much one should wean oneself away from other karmas also, laukika karmas also. Anyway, with that we'll stop here. We'll see you in the next part. Sukhan nityam subprakasham vyapakan namarupi adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher drukyatnu nirmalam aparam sarvedanta vedyam pratyak paramaha tadevan matto nyadithime nishchitamatihi tatsudha. Namaste.